Hello and welcome back to Seaside Garage. I'm gonna do some more work to the Skoda today. My plan for today is to rebuild the carb and the fuel pump. I'm having slight issues starting the car, which could be a bit normal, but I think it's a bit excessive on this one. And also I had an issue, a small breakdown a week ago, where the carb got clogged with something and I cleaned it out on the road and it worked fine afterwards. But I would like to just go through it and change the seals and all that. So I have actually already taken off the carb and the fuel pump. And this means that the airbox has to come off. Some wires, only one wire actually. A breather for the crankcase and a breather, not a breather, but a heat tube from the exhaust for cold start. And then I have removed the carb. It's held on by four bolts. And right down there, it's difficult to see right now, but there is the fuel pump and I have taken that one off as well. And I have emptied the fuel out of the carb and cleaned it up just a little bit before I'm gonna take it apart, just to avoid getting too much grit and dirt into the carb when taking it apart. So the plan is to take this one all apart, clean it up a little bit. I'm not gonna go mad about the cleaning, but just a little bit. The inside needs to be clean, of course. And then new gaskets, new springs and new rubbers and so on. After that, we're going to take this one apart. This is the fuel pump and also fuel filter. A bit like a boat, actually. I haven't seen this installation on cars before. The pump is pretty normal, but not the filter type. This is just one huge rubber diaphragm. And we're just gonna put a new one in, clean it up, and then it should be good to go. I actually have a feeling that the fuel is leaking back from this one and into the tank, which makes the cranking time quite long before the pressure is built up. The pressure is built up on the pump by this little rod right there that is pushed against by the, I think it's the, I'm unsure if it's the crank or the camshaft on this one, but then it will just pump. And if there's nothing to pump, it will take a long time to get the fuel up and through the system. But we'll start with the carb. Let's take it apart. So I'm gonna start by removing all the screws for the top cover. Then I should be able to just take the cover off. Well, maybe not, because this one is, no, that's loose already. Like that. And then I'm gonna take out all of the jets and emulsion tubes and all that. And try to remember where they are going back in. And then this carb should actually have some glass balls somewhere. And it should be very easy to lose them, a little bit like a Velo Solex, but I will have to check up on those so I don't lose it. I think there is one underneath this acceleration pump, actually. If I can get it up. Yes, this is pretty easy to lose, but we will try not to. I'm laying the jets and the emulsion tubes and all that the way they came out. That will make it easier to assemble it the same way. This, I believe, is the choke mechanism that I believe richens the mixture. And then there is the diaphragm that pumps fuel in when you need to accelerate. This is one of those things that very often gets hard or brittle and doesn't pump very, very well. And this is the case on this one. It's completely hard right here. It's pretty soft over here, but it's not pumping. It is not pumping efficiently, that's for sure. So it will be a very good thing to change this. This will make the acceleration response a lot smoother and a lot better. So that's good. I believe there is a glass ball in this hole as well, but I can't see any. So I could be mistaken. Maybe it's underneath this little screw. Yep, there we go. Another little ball. I believe that this is the air correction screw, the big one, and the small one is the mixture screw. So I can set the idle with this and then the mixture with this, and then yeah, should be all right. I'm gonna take it out, counting the revolution to take them out just to get them in the same position. So I'm gonna tighten it up first. Two and a half turn in. So two and out, of course. Two and a half turn out is the setting it was to begin with. So what I'm going to do is to ride at the nozzle. Two and a half. That way I know that this one is two and a half turn out from totally in. That will help me when I assemble it again. I'm going to do the same with the small mixture screw. But what I'm going to do now, off camera, is to clean this one up and make sure everything is nice and clean, and blow the holes and blow through the holes with some compressed air, and then it should be ready to be reassembled. So now let the rebuild begin. It's cleaned, not perfect, but good enough. This one needs to be pulled out. I have a bit of a struggle to take it out, but it happened. And now I'm just gonna do it part by part and change all the rubbers and so on. There we go. It's off. Then the acceleration pump I will actually install on the car, because it is almost impossible to get to the last nut with the acceleration pump installed. So I'm gonna do that when it is installed. That will make it a lot easier for me. This is the day after I begun, because I ran out of time yesterday. This is not my full-time job. It may come as a surprise for you, but it is not. Sometimes I have to do other stuff. This is ready to be installed on the car again. But before that, I'm going to take a look at that very funky looking fuel pump. Let's take a look at that. Ugh. I don't think fuel is supposed to be black, so I think there's some gunk inside of here. I'm just gonna clean it up a bit on the outside. And it is not perfect, but it is a lot better. Now I'm gonna take all the screws out to get access to that big rubber diaphragm in there. Oh, it's going to be so very exciting. Oh. There is some fuel in here at least. There we go. Well, it really isn't bad at all. So I'm not expecting a lot of difference from this, at least. It's a bit hard out here, but it's not that bad. Anyway, we're gonna change it. We're gonna clean it out a little bit. I think I made a lot of this outside of the camera reach, so I think you won't be able to see much of what I have done, but the new diaphragm is in, and I'm just tightening everything back up. I just looked at the viewfinder on the camera and realized that I was not really filming anything other than like this. So, yeah. Like this. It sounds as though it's working quite well. The filter, I'm gonna clean. Like so. I am going to fit this to the car and take you back in a minute. So the carb is back in and the fuel pump is back in and everything is back together. Yeah, I'm sorry that this video was not more in details and it was a bit hastily put together and a bit hastily done. But I need my Skoda to be working, so I hope you can bear with me. But to try to make it up, let's make a cold start of the Skoda and see if it all works now. But before trying, let's prime the fuel pump. It should be all good now. So let's see. So I'm gonna pull the choke. Then I'm going to pump the pedal 3 times. And then I'm gonna turn the key. Oh no, there's no more power on it. The battery is a bit dead, I think. Even with a dead battery, This Skoda is amazing. Wow. So the carb rebuild must have been a success because it can start even though the battery was flat. That's impressive. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.